just wanted to introduce my vlog before I completely forget. I'm just outside the Apollo Victoria Theatre now. I've collected my tickets. I'm just gonna go grab some dinner, probably at Giraffe, I think, meet some friends there, and then I'm going to see Rachel Tucker's return show to Wicked. I'm so excited. I'm just approaching the theatre now, and there's the biggest queue outside. So, this is the first time I've had to queue up to get into the Apollo Victoria. Mad times. Let's see how long this takes. And it feels weird. Doesn't it feel weird, gals?
Yeah, really.
No one's in shot. Oh, this is new. Oh, wow. Everything is new. There was a walkway to the toilets before, and now that's a bar. Great, good. It doesn't feel like we're about to see Rachel Tucker in Wicked again. They've changed all the seats as well, which I don't know how keen I am on. But yeah, it's exciting.
Wow! Thanks, guys. I love that. That's so cool.
Are you ready, guys?
She can film.
Again, everyone, as you can tell, I'm home now. It's actually the next day. I found that I wasn't really kind of talking to the camera much last night because there were so many people that I knew there that I obviously wanted to catch up with. I didn't want to like thrust a camera in their face or like just be talking to a camera the whole time. And then afterwards at stage door, we were just having so much fun talking and laughing and like discussing the show, and it just felt really nice, and I didn't want to ruin that by like, yeah, getting the camera out and putting it in people's faces. So I thought instead I will just sit down right now and talk to you about the show. It's been quite a while since I last saw Wicked. I think it was in February. I am really glad actually that I haven't seen it that much this year, because I think it made this show even more amazing. It was so good. Apologies, by the way, if you can hear cars and stuff outside. It's been so humid in London today, I can't bear not having the window open. Obviously for this show, I was most excited about the fact that Rachel was back. She was back green on the West End. I was so excited to see her again. I can't even describe how excited I was. It didn't feel real before the show. I met up with some friends for dinner and we all just kept saying, we can't believe we're seeing Rachel Green again tonight in the West End. It just felt really surreal, as if we literally just like time traveled back to 2012. It really didn't sink in until the actual show. A lot of things have changed within the actual theatre since I was last there. A lot of the merchandise is different. They've completely upholstered the seats, so they're completely different since I was last there. And overall, it felt like a kind of different theatre to be in. I love that theatre though. The Apollo Victoria is gorgeous. I was sat in one of the side seats in C13. And these used to be really cheap seats, so I sat in them quite a lot of times. I knew the view that I was going in for, and I actually really like sitting on that side. Other people prefer sitting on, so I was like on the right side of the auditorium facing the stage, and a lot of people prefer the left side because the Alpha Burr is normally like near that side of the stage more often. But I don't know, I like the right side because I feel like it's less restricted. Those end seats are technically restricted, but yeah, I prefer the right hand side ones. The minute the show started, I just felt that kind of magic come back. Like the first time I saw it and the first times that I like really got into it. And that was a really nice feeling because I haven't really had it the last few times that I've seen the show. Obviously the last time I saw Rachel was on Broadway last year. So it was a completely different show in a way. There was lots of changes. The accent was totally different. So it wasn't the same for me. Throughout the whole show, I was really, really impressed with the whole cast. The ensemble from the minute the show started were incredible. It was not like it was their first show. I haven't really been keeping up with the cast changes recently, but I think it was quite a big cast change last weekend. Obviously both Elphaba and Glinda have completely changed. Madame Morrible, Bok, Dr. De- yeah, it was a big change when I think about it. So I think actually out of the main kind of principal cast, it's only Oliver Saville as Fiero and Katie Raleigh-Jones as Nessa Rose that have stayed on. So that's a really like refreshed cast. Obviously, Rachel Tucker. When she ran out on stage, so many people cheered and it was amazing. I love it when that happens. I think actually people were clapping at like when the show started, and I think that kind of sets the tone for the whole show, that the audience is pumped, it's ready, and like we're so excited for this show. And it definitely helps, and it's amazing when the audience kind of claps so much that it pauses the show a little bit. I just think it's amazing. Susie Mathis, I might actually be like one of my favorite Glindas now. I thought she was incredible. I was a bit, I'm not nervous. I was interested to see what her accent was going to be like, because she's Australian. Yes, she's Australian. and I presumed that in the Australian production, she'd kind of keep her accent, or it would be slightly Americanized, but it was a really good neutral accent. I was really impressed. Her singing voice is stunning. Her popular was hilarious. It was perfect. She was great. She's definitely my favorite Glinda in like a long while. I'm pretty sure last time I saw Wicked, I wasn't that keen on Oliver Saville, but this time I loved his Fiero. So good. And I think just the chemistry this whole cast have is really amazing. And I'm not sure whether it's because they're all really pumped to be part of the 10th anniversary cast, so naturally they've got that really special bond together already and that kind of that thing, but they just really, really work together so well. I was really pleasantly surprised by Anita Dobson and Mark Curry as Madame Morrible and the Wizard. They were really, really good. There was a couple of moments where I thought that Anita could have actually been meaner as Morrible. I think she was maybe a bit too nice in the first act, but definitely in the second act that turned around. I found it interesting that with Mark, you really empathised with him in the first act, and then by the second act you were like, nah, this guy's a douche. I wasn't a massive fan of the last Bok the production had, and I was really interested to see what Idris Carbo, I'm not going to say his name wrong because I asked him at stage door last night, I was like, how do you say your last name? Pretty sure he said it was Carbo. He is the sassiest Bok I've ever seen, and I loved it. You just keep on being that sassy little Bok, because I'm living for it. Well, I think it's quite obvious that I absolutely loved the show. It's really kind of reignited my Wicked fangirl, so pray for my bank account. This cast is perfect for the 10th anniversary, and I am so excited for that show. I cannot wait. I'll definitely be seeing Wicked more now that Rachel's back. Old habits die hard and all that. So I'll be doing a more comprehensive review of the show when I've seen it again and kind of taken in a bit more, because when you're that excited for something, you just don't really take it in properly, do you? Also, I'm kind of tempted to do a Wicked Q&A. If you're interested in that, let me know in the comments and leave me some questions, whether it's to do with the different casts I've seen, going to see the show, tickets and stuff like that. Any questions you have, let me know. As usual, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up if you have, and subscribe to my channel if you'd like to see more from me in the future. I hope you're all well, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!
When I saw that Sarah Harding and Andy Moss were cast in Ghost, I was like, wow, okay, great.